Good YouTube, it's your boy Millie Man, and I'm back here with another Forex video. If you don't know by now, I'm rebranding my channel to Forex. Quick summary, it's like stock, it's investing, the candlesticks, reading candlesticks, you know, profiting off of when they buy themselves, etc. But we basically about to be reviewing Mamba FX's website, claritytraders.com, and we are taking the challenge right now, so I'm gonna kind of go over what it is, how I'm doing, and just kind of overall my thoughts. And I got a question that might help some other traders that are going through, maybe thinking about a prop firm or maybe in a prop firm and need some tips, help. Let me keep watching. If you're new though, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Definitely subscribe. I will be documenting my journey with Forex, and it's gonna be an exciting one. I feel like I'm one of the top scalpers on this platform, on this platform. And I just want to let my actions speak, you know? So yeah, just keep on like following the journey and you're going to find out if I become that or not. So yeah, let's get right into it though. Let's go here first, actually. So boom, man, my account balance is $54,778. Right now I'm up 9.5%, which you have to be up 10%. Actually, let me go through that real quick right now. So, boom. So, in Mamba's prop firm, he actually gives the opportunity to do a single-phase challenge instead of a two-phase challenge like majority of the rest of the prop firms do. You have to pass two steps and then funded account. Here, he gives a one step and then pass funded account. I don't think I've heard it anywhere else, but when I heard that, I jumped on it and I've been here ever since. They have 25,000 all the way up to 200,000. I'm on the 50,000 right now, trying to pass that. I started with 25,000, but I'll get into that later. So yeah, there's 50K and 100K. And if you come down here, you can trade on MetaTrader 4, 5, and Trade Locker. I only use MetaTrader 4. That's $300 and 100K is 500. 200K, 1,000. So that's how much it will take for you to actually take the challenge. It's not free. So you have to pay to take the challenge. Then you have to meet these parameters. So you have to profit 10% of, you know, whatever one you choose. And you have unlimited to do it. 1 to 100 leverage, one minimum trading day. You cannot lose 4% in a day. You cannot lose 4% of your account in one day or you will lose the challenge. And you can't lose more than 6% overall or you will lose the challenge. You have to pay again to take it. The $25,000 account, this is this. I failed it because I didn't even like peep one of the rules, which was the drawdown. Can't be a certain percent in drawdown. And I wasn't even thinking about it and basically went over that. So that right after that, I was like, wait, how did I lose? I was like mad confused how I lost. And then I was like, I texted the support. By the way, their support is really good. 24/7 and quick replies. And they actually answer what you have to say. So solid feedback for me. But yeah, I went to the 50K account because I was like, okay, I know I could do this. Right. And it's only $100 extra. And I had that. So I paid for it. Right here is the numbers that I usually look at when I'm trading live. So the next trading live day for me will be Monday morning, 7:38. I can't lose more than 2.1. There's no rounding up. It's that exact number. I feel like this would change when the day restarts. But if not, then I can't lose 7,000. But it doesn't matter because this will play first. I've been trading for 15 days now. Honestly thought I would be done by now, but I'm channeling my disciplined self. I know that say in the future, say like I'm 2 months in, say I was like felt like I'm taking too long, right? And I'm like trying to switch on my approach and say either I fail or I just like lose percentage or whatever, you know, just go downhill. It's like I'll be looking back at this time right now where it says I'm at 15 days or whatever, and I'll be thankful, you know, I'll be happy that it's only been 15 days, you know. So I'd rather understand that it could be worse and just do what I got to do. You know, this is my first pot fairing, so there's a lot of importance I'm putting on passing this. And then right here, the profit target, all I need is $221, man. I had to make $5,000. I'm at $4,778 right here. So $221 left. That's super. That's one trade. I'm literally a trade away. But right here, highest profit day. This right here is what's going to take a little bit longer. I could pass this by Monday or even Sunday when it opens. But I want to be disciplined. So Monday, I'll be trading on Monday. So that means I have to consistently profit under $1,500. So this highest profit day was the most confusing. Because I remember one time I profited more than 1500, which is, I guess, more than 30% of 50,000. My percentage spiked up, and basically I've been kind of going like profit, then I lose a little bit, profit, lose a little bit. And it got to a point where I was at 2% of my account, like up 2%, and I was up like 7% or 6%. And so I was like, you know what, man, I'm done playing. And recently I made this $2,500 day, and like I said, can't go over 30% of your account. That boosted my percentage up a lot. So right now I'm in the process of getting it down, and once I get it down, I'm done, you know? So that's my journey right now. That's where I'm currently at right now. I'm going to answer this person's question, give some advice, and then I'm going to wrap this video up. The question is, yo, what's up, bro? I just wanted to know how you feel about prop firms and if you have any tips for passing it. Thanks. Okay, so how I feel about prop firms. Man, right now, it's a no-brainer. I think of prop firms as a no-brainer if you know how to trade. If not, then focus on learning how to trade, you know, becoming profitable. But once you know how to trade and you feel like you know what to do and you know how to do, you know, what you're doing, follow your strategies and stuff, I'd say go for a prop firm. It's a cheat code in my book. Like, I feel like on this channel, I'm going to be praising prop firms a lot. Not even praising, but just like on that journey. Because I feel like I'm going to really make it work. Because it's like too good to be true type of feeling. And I'm super close to it. So I'm going to really see if it's too good to be true. That's why you guys need to follow the journey. Because this is me. I'm documenting myself before having a funded account and profiting off a funded account. So for the real traders that's out there, you understand it's a shift in finances. Yeah. I'm broke right now. Should you say that? I'm not really broke, but I'm not where I want to be. So yeah, that's all. But any tips for passing, which was the second question. I'd say follow your rules. Like, you need to have a risk management kind of plan when you are trading. For example, me, because this is my first account, I know I'm going to go different ways in different accounts. Like, once I have like 3 accounts, 4 accounts, whatever. But right now I trade 1%. Cause even if I lost, you know, I'll be down 1%, but then the next trade I can catch a 1-2 and I'll be up 1%. So kind of like starting off slow, starting off, strong mentally wise, and you know, for the chart. And when I get up more than 2%, I'll risk 2%. You know, if I get more than 3%, I'll risk 3%. But I only risk 3% once. And I made, it's actually right here, I made 2,500. And that's what spiked my number up. So I have to basically risk 1% for the remainder of this till it goes down. But for you all, for the tip, I'd say stick to a percentage that you're okay with. And I'd say 1% is no, if you know how to trade and you know what you're doing, 1% is fine. You just got to be patient. It's not like you're going to jump right to the target, you know, especially if you trade 1 to 2 times a day. You have to wait to the next trading day, do it again, perform each day. And that's the thing that a lot of people can't do. Be disciplined and patient. Man, what? The market is open 24/5. So it's like this mad opportunity to just make money and lose money and lose your calm and focus. So yeah, stick to your plans, your rules, and be disciplined and patient and understand why you're doing. I feel like understanding what's on the line, I feel like would whip you in shape before blowing like 2-3 accounts would whip you into shape. But like, just get it, just understand that prop firms are a blessing and treat it seriously. That's how I'm treating it. Like, I've dropped everything and now everything's gonna be adapting to me doing this prop firm. That's how I just like that. And yeah, we almost about to finish. So yeah, y'all stay on y'all path and y'all should be good. And I hope y'all enjoyed. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, and let me know what other videos you would like to see, like day in the life, me playing the game while making money, or me making a beat while making money, live strategies. Let me know, y'all. Let me know. I have a lot of plans in the future, but if you guys want to see something, let me know. I'm gonna do car conversations, me in a car with certain topics, so stay tuned to that. A lot of psychology and yeah, a lot of documenting the journey, how I feel. That definitely stay tuned for that. But it's been your boy Millie. Peace.